that NBC2 brought you the story earlier this month. A sex offender is living next door to a school and a playground in Lee County.
State law allows Jody Kulling to live closer than other offenders. NBC2's Chris Gilmore has spent the past 2 weeks digging into Kulling's history and repeat past of living near young children.
It's an issue the Lee County Sheriff's Office is aware of, but until he does something illegal, their hands are tied.
You saw our story 2 weeks ago on registered sex offender Jody Kulling. He's currently listed as living within 1,000 feet of Colonial Elementary and Trailhead Park in Fort Myers.
To be around an elementary school with the young girls and young kids like that shouldn't be.
You asked us to dig deeper, so we tracked down the father of one of Kulling's victims from more than 10 years ago. He wasn't happy to learn of Kulling's current whereabouts.
And I feel for the other parents, because wherever he's at, he's going to be a problem. More than likely.
We went further into Kulling's past and found this isn't the first time he's lived this close to a school. A 2003 arrest report shows Kulling living across the street from Tice Elementary, exposing himself to kids from his bedroom.
If you take a step out into the street in front of the window where Kulling used to expose himself, you can see Tice Elementary School's playground is clearly visible.
Neighbors still remember the crime and the man in the window.
He didn't need to be here exposing himself to the children going through here. And there's lots of children go through here.
According to the arrest report, the assistant principal worked with the sheriff's office to record Kulling exposing himself. Kulling was convicted and sentenced to 10 years in prison. Polling was upset to learn the sex offender is still legally allowed to live within 1,000 feet of schools.
Legislators need to change this, and that's the only way it's going to be changed. And if it has to be changed, get it on the ballot. I'll be more than happy to vote for it.
The Lee County Sheriff's Office tells us they routinely check in on Kulling every month. He's also required to notify the deputies if he moves. In the studio, Chris Gilmore, NBC.